One of the first pieces of Oxford Group literature that I came across is this little pamphlet here, and it is entitled How to Listen to God. And it kind of sums up some of the basic philosophy of the meditation practices and the beliefs that Oxford Group people had and early AA people inherited. Some of the key factors, God has a plan for your life. God will tell you what you need to know in order to follow that plan. Maybe he won't tell you everything you need to know, but enough. And God will give you the power that you need to accomplish it. Anyone can be in touch with God, it says. Certain conditions must be met. What are they? Be still and listen. Write the thoughts that come, and then test the thoughts, because every thought is not going to be coming from God. So they tested them by honesty, purity, unselfishness, and love. If it met that test, chances were pretty good. If it was a big question that you had, they'd say, talk it over with somebody else who's also practicing quiet time. So it wasn't that they just, it's not like a seance that you get this information and off you go. But if you're trying to live by the absolutes, really trying to live and ask the question, what is God's will for me? What is he really asking of me? Their belief was he will communicate that to you in some way. Now, what I've done is kind of take that information and modernize it a little bit. And so what I want to do now is sort of work you guys through this process. So here's what it boils down to. Number one, preparation. You make a commitment that you're willing to practice quiet time for 10, 15 minutes for the next 30 days. Would you be willing to do that? Each morning, to give it 10 or 15 minutes. Do it in the morning. If I can negotiate on this a little bit. If it's absolutely impossible, afternoon, evening, okay. But primarily, it was morning time, when you're just getting up. That's the time to best do it. Choose a sacred spot, a usual spot where you can go to. In India, everyone, no matter how poor they are, they've got a little altar in their home. A sacred spot where they can go to, and they know that they're going to meet God when they go to that place. So I have a chair in my computer room. It's a green leather chair. I go there. I don't read the newspaper there. I only go there to practice my quiet time. Then you get yourself a notebook. Just any spiral notebook will do. And then you're ready to go. Okay, so how to begin now? Well, number one is you sit in an upright posture. It doesn't have to be rigid, okay? But you don't have your feet sprawled on the desk in front of you. You got to remember into whose presence you are coming. So can you cross your leg? I get asked. Yes, you can. You get comfortable but respectful, all right? Then they would read a short passage. This, I think, is somewhat optional. But if some sacred reading, and I always ask people, make it not another meditation book, because you're going to do your own, all right? But some sacred literature that works for you, okay, that you're comfortable with, that speaks to you. Take in a few deep breaths. Breathe yourself kind of coming into God's presence and breathe out the fear, the angst, the whatever is going on in your life. Breathe in God's presence. Let go of your fear, your anxiety. And then you begin to write. You write a question, okay? You write a question. Some sample questions might be something like this. God, I've tried getting clean and sober before. Please tell me what I need to do that's different this time. All right? Father, I feel so alone. I feel separated from you. Please help me to feel your presence. The other might be, I don't even know who you are. Please talk to me. You come from what's real in you. Lord, I need guidance today because something big is coming up in my life. And you write down just what that something big is. I'm afraid. Please help me. That's all. Short little question. But the key is it's an honest question. It's coming from a genuine need. All right? And then what do? You listen for God's voice. Carl Jung used to call this active imagination. If God were to speak to you, what might he say? Let it happen. This is creative writing 101. If God were to speak to you, if the most loving presence in the universe were to come into your life, what is it that you are longing to hear from him? And then let it go. Let it happen. Just write, all right? Pour it out, all right? You write the words that come. You don't try not to edit them. If you get stuck, one of the things I've found that's really helpful is if you will use a term of endearment, my beloved, my child, my brother, my son, God talking to me like that, try it and see if it doesn't begin to trigger within you that intimacy that we're really, really looking for and searching for. And then stop when it feels like it's becoming forced. I generally do 5, maybe 7 minutes at a time. And then when it's done, put it down. And then feel God's presence. There's a whole other form of prayer and meditation called contemplative prayer. And that's the sort of prayer where you sit and you just sort of let your mind go free and you don't think anything. I find alcoholics and addicts are not terribly good at that. You know, half of us suffer from ADD. And this method is kind of nice because you don't have to go to total silence. You let it play out in your mind. But you know what? At the end of it, you're going to find yourself in silence. You're going to find yourself connected to God. And he's just given you the answer to something that your heart has been longing to hear, maybe for many, many years. So do you have something that's troubling you? Something you need help with? If nothing comes to mind, I'd suggest maybe you start with one of the absolutes. Start with honesty. It's usually the big one. Is there some area in my life where I'm still dishonest? Lord, help me. And then listen, okay? So I'm going to ask you to do that and take about 5-7 minutes, and then we're going to come back and see how it's gone for you. So just at your places there, go for it. Thanks.